high-ranking Army and Navy officers aboard an American warship somewhere in the North Atlantic. There's General Arnold, Air Corps Chief, as well as Admirals King and Star, awaiting the epoch-making meeting of President Roosevelt and Prime Minister Churchill of Britain. Sumner Wells and Harry Hopkins are here, too. And now the President, accompanied by his son Franklin D. Jr. as aide, while awaiting Churchill, greets the arriving British officers and experts, among them the British Minister of Supply, Lord Beaverbrook. It's an historic moment as the heads of the two great English-speaking nations meet, a meeting followed by a series of conferences that result in the announcement of joint U.S. and British war aims. An eight-point announcement, reminiscent of President Wilson's 14 points, giving hope and encouragement to Nazi-oppressed nations and heralding a final destruction of Nazi tyranny. A forecast of democracy's new order for all the world. Wales. Church service, attended by the leaders and their conference staffs. Prayers for victory and peace amid the grim setting of British and American naval strength. In an unprecedented meeting, the leaders of democracy plan out the road to world peace.